Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to discuss about rolling file appender. Why we need to use rolling file appender? Means if you are not using rolling file appender, means so all your logs will be updated in a single file. So what happened, whenever you are running your applications, logs will store in same log and the log file size will be increased. So at the point of time, if you want to open and see the logs, so it will take long time for opening because logs is containing more data. So for opening that file, it will take more time. So for removing those dependencies, we can create different same log with some set of data. Suppose you can see. You can create each file rolling with 1 MB, 2 MB, 3 MB, like that, based on your requirement. So for our understanding purpose, here I am creating logs will roll for each 1 KB, and same thing I am doing the backup for logs. So I am giving the max backup is a 3. So what happened, after giving those properties in log4j, whenever you are generating the logs, it will check whether the file is 1 KB is present or not. If not, it will print the logs into same file. Once the file is reached to 1 KB, it will stop the printing logs into same file. It will generate one backup file with .123, and it will generate new log and it will print all data into the new logs. Okay, let's go how we can programmatically we can configure. So here in Java files, nothing need to change. So in log4j property file only we need to change. Here instead of file appender, I am using rolling file appender. So I am commenting here, control V, rolling file appender. I am giving the max size .max file size. I am giving 2 KB. And one more thing, how many max data backup .max backup index is 3. So I am giving file size is a 2 KB and I am going to backup 3 files. So here log4j, here if you observe there is no logs is present. Here I am running my log4j program. So I am running the program, control F11, max file size, sorry the content is, I mean the name is wrong. So size, okay, just save the program and run it. So clear the console and running the program. So here it's already generated. I'm removing the file. The file is removed. Now I am going to run the program once again. Control F11. See, file is generated. Still it's a 1 KB only. So now I am running one more time. Control F11. Still 1 KB. Control F11. See, now file is changed to 2 KB. So how much KB I have given? I have given 2 KB. So now file is 2 KB. So let's see whether it will roll or not. I'm pressing Control F11 again. Control F11. See, if you observe here, once it is crossed to 2 KB, so it generated backup file with the .txt.1 and it generated new file. So observe, I have given 3 backups. control F11, control F11. Just observe on top first file. Say 2 KB reached. See 3 KB. See observe here. One more dot 2 is generated. So again I am generating. See now max 3 backup files is generated and now it's came to 0. So I have given maximum 3. If you are trying to run again, so at the last one this dot 3 will be removed and it will change to dot 2 to 3, 1 to 2, and a new one will come as a 1. See, it won't generate new index file. 1 KB. Observe it changed, but that backup file is not generated. Means we have given maximum 3 backup files only. So here in log4j properties, what we configured is extra for this. We have given appender name is a rolling file appender, and we have given what is the maximum file size for our logs. 2 KB we have given, and we have given what is the backup index. Backup index means it will store that many backup files in your system. Okay, thanks friends, thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Thank you very much.